Hello, everybody. Welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather, and we are in the Kraaft Shack. And I almost forgot how to do this because I've been not so live for a couple weeks. So, but I think we'll figure it out as we go. I've got with me my amazing friends, Sylvia and Sandra, and they're going to be here to say hello to everybody, to answer questions or bring up questions as they come. If you happen to be watching us live on YouTube, then you just might be wondering where you can leave comments, and that is done on our website. You'll need to go to kraaftshack.com/live to figure that out. The link is in the description of the video, and I think we're ready to get started. What do you guys think?
I think we're ready too. I'm anxious to see this.
All right. Hi, everybody. Welcome.
Thank you guys, both of you, for being here. I really do appreciate it. It's always awesome to have the two of you here with us. I do want to show the idea behind what we're going to do. And I also need to clarify that it is a two-part video. So part one is today. Part two, we'll finish it all up next week. Same bat channel, same bat place. So this is the, is that backwards? No, that's the right way. So this is the sketch that I gave to the patrons this morning, and this was the idea that I had floating in my head. And I made a little tiny sketch, just like, you know, took a pencil and went. And yeah, I think that's what I want to do. So then I made it bigger and outlined it and gave it to the patrons for anyone at $1 or more. So they have that to play along if they'd like. And if you do play along, please post in the crafters community so everyone can see what you do with it. I think that's it. I think we're going to say hello to everybody, and I'm going to switch cameras. Okay, sound good?
Okay, sounds great. Okay, well, I'm going to welcome everybody who's here, and I want to give a big shout out to Linz. Linz is joining us for the first time in a long time. And if you don't follow Linz, you need to, because she does the Kraaft Shack cartoons, and the cartoon that she did this time is absolutely amazing. Of course, every single one that she does is truly amazing. She's very gifted, and we're very honored to have her with us. So I'm so glad to see you back, Linz. And I want to say hi to Andrew and Michael and Jazzy and BJ, and we're sending out some prayers and some good thoughts for BJ because she's not feeling too well. And Lon is here, and Carol and Mary and Lisa and Linda Kay, Jules, Angel, who is Orla, Michael Ann, Trisha, Lassie, who is Jet, and Linz Kelch-Bush. She's joining us, I think, for the first time. She's joining us, I see, from Facebook. So welcome aboard, everybody.
Welcome, everyone. Today's message. Let me see if I can remember how to put it up. There it is. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Philippians 4:8.
I like that.
It is right. Focus on the good stuff.
Yeah, exactly. Focus on the good stuff. All right. Okay, so what I have today, and thank you, ladies, both of you, very much for that. We appreciate it. What I have for you guys today is a canvas panel. It measures 16 by 20 inches. And we are going to be taking this image and applying it to the larger surface. So I wanted to show you how I do that. Let's see if I can back up just a little bit without breaking everything, because we know what happens to my lighting when I do that. All right, I've got a graphite pencil. This is a graphite stick. It is like so cool. Anyway, huge. Okay, can't get the paper off of the canvas. Hold on. Okay, so what I want to do is I'm going to set this over here so that you can still see it. And I'm going to take my large graphite pencil, and I'm going to create for myself a border. And I'm just going to start like diagonally from that corner right there. It's a couple inches, just eyeballing it. And then I want to make a line, but I don't want it to be straight. I could use a ruler, but I really want it to look a lot more whimsical. So this curvature here is kind of cool. I like that.
Heather.
Yeah.
You have to talk about the tool you're using right now.
It's a graphite pencil.
I know, but look at it. Do you see the size of that thing? That's solid graphite, people. We got that when she was here in Arizona.
Yes, and I like it. What do you want me to say? You do have to buy a special sharpener for it, though, because it's fat. I mean, it's really big around, but it's so cool because it is solid graphite and it feels good in your hand, and then, you know, you draw with it, you never run out. Never. There's no way. Even me, I won't run out. And it comes in different softnesses and hardnesses. But anyway,
so just use an emery board to sharpen it too, you know, one of those, you know, drafting board sharpeners.
Yeah, I haven't tried that yet because I'm not very good at that, but I wanted to get to a really good point and be even, so I like my sharpener. But okay, so the next thing that I would do, because this is a simple drawing, that's my border that I'm going to do a mosaic on, and then I'm going to go to, hopefully you can see this, right here from the inside of this border over is just a little bit on both sides. So if I were to just start like this, that's pretty good. And then I would draw him, it's just a real simple shape, just draw it like that. And not as pointy. And maybe make it stop about there. And this doesn't have to be exact, so keep that in mind. And I've already done one, so I just wanted you to see, this is what I did. Use this, and I created this for you. Then I darkened it up because we couldn't really see it on screen. So I did go over it again with the pencil and made it much darker. So that is how I transferred this to that. Now, my idea is I want this to look old. I want it to look like it's been around a long time. And you know, when you're looking at an ancient painting, I say ancient, it's, you know, a couple hundred years old, and you're looking at the painting and you see cracks, and sometimes they need to be restored. Well, I want to do that on purpose so that this looks much older than it actually is. So, and yes, you can use regular old drawing pencils. You don't have to have the big old fancy pencil like that, but they're just awesome. Okay, so what I'm going to do is use crackle paste for their faces. And we're going to start with, if you watched last week's Not So Live show, I used quinacridone gold. I used quinacridone gold and crackle paste and put them together and created a nice paste that went around. I'm having trouble finding my mixing palette thing. That went around the outside of that canvas or wooden panel, I guess. So I'm going to do kind of the same thing, but it's not going to be as dark. Did you guys leave me? Am I all alone?
Yeah, just watching. I'm watching you mix.
Is there any chance that one of you could run upstairs and get the rest of my stuff? No? Okay, fine. I think I forgot some things upstairs, but that's okay. We'll make do. Please feel free to bring up any comments or whatever as they come, because I am just trying to get through this. It's been a little while since we've done this.
Oh, we have a comment from Michael of what your image reminded him, your sketch reminded him.
Okay.
He says that right now it looks like broken thumbs.
Broken thumbs, yes. typical Michael. Nativity, broken thumbs. It's practically the same message.
Same thing.
All right, so all I did was put some quinacridone gold mixed with that crackle paste from Deco Art.
Oh, that's a nice flesh color.
Yeah, that's kind of what I thought. That's what I actually thought when I was doing that other piece, but you guys weren't around to tell it to, so, you know, I did that whole recording by myself. It was boring. Thank goodness, everybody. Thank you, Sylvia and Sandra, for being here, right?
And yeah, everybody in the audience, we have a nice full audience today.
Oh, awesome. Okay, so I have my mixture, and I didn't do a lot because it's, you know, it's not a lot of space here. But the reason why I'm starting with their faces is because I want to put all the other layers on top of their face. So I want them to have, I don't want to do the face last. It'll stick out, you know, like a sore thumb.
Way to go, Michael.
Boo, hiss. Okay, anyway.
Where's that laugh track?
Yeah, I know. We need one when I make jokes like that. All right, so just using my palette knife to put a nice layer of crackle paste. And if you watched that video, if you didn't watch that video, it's still available. It's on YouTube. It's also in our video treasure chest. You can go watch it there with all the comments and everything, where Miss Linz was so missed that we thought she was gone for months and months when it was just that 1 week that she missed. But anyway.
When we don't hear from Linz, it's like part of you is missing, you know?
And, I agree. Totally agree with that. So no more missing Linz for our sake, please. Okay. It's decided she can't be absent anymore. So now in the thicker places where you put it on thicker, it's going to have much bigger cracks. So I don't know if that, you know, would matter or not, but since these won't have any actual facial features, that'll add to the character of them. So you don't really want to mess with this too much, but it doesn't take long for this stuff to dry. So we may even get to put the antiquing cream on, which is what I was getting at about what we did last week. We put antiquing cream on our cracks after they dried, and it surely makes a difference. Oh, it makes such a difference. So it's hard to move a 16 by 20 canvas panel around on your tiny little workstation here, I must say. This would be a good place to use my new easel, but I don't know how to use it yet and the camera at the same time. So that's coming.
That's a nice size, though. It's going to be nice when it's done.
I hope so. I hope so. All right, I need another spatula or something to get all the rest of this off. So this is what I'm going to use.
Finger.
No, I'm not going to use my finger. I'm going to use an old credit card, room key, whatever thing. And maybe not even get it off there. Okay, there we go. Good Lord.
The struggles are real, people.
Yes, they are real. That is true. All right, that should do it. I don't know why I have this blue stuff. Oh, it must be the gunk that was on that card. That's nice. All right, we'll just set that aside. Okay, so that is that part done. Now, this mixed media piece is going to have things like crackle paste. We're going to use paper, jelly plate prints that I've made in the past on many, many, many different videos that we've done together, and we're putting it all together on one thing with paint and everything else. That's what makes it mixed media. We're mixing a bunch of mediums together to create today's image and next week's image. So I think from here, the next thing I want to do is do the mosaic border around the outside. I've pulled aside, let me move this for a minute. I've pulled aside some of the prints that I've had in my stash from various projects between, I think these I made when we were doing the buffalo. I think that's what these were from. Remember when we used a round jelly plate on a whatever roundy-bouty thing? There's a lot of that here. Different colors. I was trying really hard to go with darker colors, but apparently I don't use those much on my jelly plate. I tend to use a lot more of the bright colors, so we're just going to go with it. If we don't like it in the end, we can always paint over it and tone it down a little bit if that's what we want to do. But these are like brayer sheets. Remember when I did the tulips and I had a paintbrush and stuff? That's what that's from. Lots of colors here. So we're going to use some of that. I might pull out some of the deli papers too, but those colors are really bright, so we'll see. Some metallics. Those will be fun to layer on top. But we'll see, okay? So I have way more than is needed. Way more. But this is one more thing that you can do with your jelly plate pulls after you've had way too much fun making all of those messes. All right, so we're going to start down here at the bottom, and I'm going to just tear. Remember on our, let's get our sketch out for a second, because I want you to see what I did here. looking at the sketch, and I did this on tracing paper. That's the reason why it looks so see-through, but I like that because I can do different things with it. I could layer it over stuff and see if it'll work, whatever. So that's why I use tracing paper. You don't have to do that. But I made little jagged lines and marks around, and I think I like it when they're bigger pieces like this than when they're smaller, bitsier pieces like down here. So we're going to aim for this look.
Larger.
Yeah, the larger pieces. So I think what I'm going to start with is this copper black, copper on top of black. I think I'm going to start with that. And just basically tear it into thirds. That'll get me started. Then I'm going to tear that into fourths. Maybe fourths. I don't know. We'll see if I can actually do fourths. Yeah, I did. All right. Those are pretty good size sheets that we can work with. Now, a mosaic truly is, you know, broken tiles. But you can do the same look with paper. And you could actually, this is what we were talking about in the green room. Do I paint the bottom of the, do I paint the canvas so that way when I put two pieces together like this, I would have a grout color in between? That's an option. I've decided not to do that. I want to save the step of painting. We're just going to put the pieces together. Not these two pieces, obviously, but we would put the pieces together, and then after it's all dry, I will go over with a black marker and create my grout lines like that. So, let's do a similar thing with this one. It's kind of neat how they end up looking when they're torn down to smaller pieces. They don't have that same overall look anymore. Makes them very interesting. So you could use just about any jelly plate pole to do this, because even your brayer off pages, because you're not looking at the full piece of paper. You're looking at the individual little strips, right?
Yeah. I love how they look so different, too.
Yeah, I mean, it's such a different thing, mm-hmm. So it's kind of cool. Also, I don't know if you can see this because I'm kind of zoomed out so you can see a lot, but there's greens and purples in with this. I'm not sure if that's coming across on screen or not, but I really like that. I wish I had two more sheets of this and I would do the whole thing that way, but we don't, so we'll make this work. All right, first thing is I have a straight edge here and a straight edge here. The one on the bottom doesn't bother me because it's going to tuck around to the back, but I don't like this crisp straight edge, so I'm going to tear that away. And I am going to leave, I am going to go right up to the line, and it, in some places it might actually cover up over into their clothing. We will be fixing that in the end when I go over the whole thing with the black paint marker, and I'll be showing you that next week probably. So the question is always, what do you use to glue it down? And my answer is always whatever you like, because I personally like matte medium. And I've been using the matte medium from Deco Art, and I like it. It works really good. So that's what we're going to stick with today. And remember I said I needed you guys to go upstairs? Neither one of you did it. So now I'm without a paintbrush. Okay, let's just use this one. Okay. Thanks a lot, guys.
Yeah, always, you know, eager to help.
Yeah, appreciate it. All right, so I'm just going to put a generous amount on the back of the paper. You've seen me do this a million times, so we should probably find something else to talk about while we're doing this.
Okay, but Michael has a question for you.
Oh, boy.
And he's learning his vocabulary, which I'm very, very proud of him, because I told him there's no C's in Kraaft Jack vocabulary. So right. He's got can, K-A-N. I ask what this final product will be. Is it like an album cover or something like that?
It is a canvas. It's a canvas to hang on your wall, put in a frame.
So there you go, Michael.
All right, I'm going to leave the edges. Eventually, they will be glued on the back. I'll probably do that off camera because there's no sense in watching me do that. But
so you're doing all copper, or are you going to do the copper?
No, I'm going to do copper like around. And I was just, as you were just asking that question, I was realizing I should probably lay some of these out to see just how much of that I'll need. And I don't want the lines going in all directions. Some things like this, like I don't need that to be that big. Just tear that off there. We'll go with that. It looks like we just might be able to do this with just these two sheets if I do it right.
Oh, so you are mixing the blue and copper.
Yeah, I think I'm going to mix the blue in there.
Okay, well, we're watching you do this. I'm going to put up this comment from Linz because Linz has got it right. Okay, she's talking about canvases. She's got the K and the two A's. Now, that's kudos.
Way to go, Linz.
Way to go, sweetie.
You get bonus points.
Yes.
For speaking Kraaft.
Yeah, when you can speak Kraaft, you get bonus points, you guys. All right, I think we can do this whole thing with just these two sheets of paper. I don't even think I need to pull out the other ones. And that'll make me very happy because I like this color scheme way more than the bright greens and all that that I had over there. So,
excellent.
We're going to go with it. And I think I'm going to alternate the, you know, the blue and the copper as best I can. Now, here's something else to recommend, to realize too. This is one-sided designer paper for scrapbooking. So it's thicker. It is a thicker paper than like your copy paper or even that deli paper, which I really wanted to use, the deli paper, because that's so much thinner. But, and I did it again. I didn't paint the back of the paper. Like, talking messes everything up. I didn't care about this sharp edge here because I know I'm going to put this over the top of it, so I think that's what we're going to do.
And it just takes, since it's thicker, it takes a little bit longer to set.
Yeah, that's where I was going with that. Thank you very much. Yeah, it's a little bit harder to glue down because it's a thicker paper. So you'll see me pull it up and put more under it. That's why. The glue needs to get onto the paper. But, you know, this is the joy of working with this matte medium because you actually end up with a workability time that you wouldn't get if you were using, like, you know, some kind of glue out of a bottle. Sometimes those are instantaneously stuck. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they dry up so much faster. I mean, it's the collage podge and that one dries up.
Yeah, collage podge is one that you stick it down, you better know where it's going. Big reason why I like the matte medium. And I'm trying really hard to make sure that I overlap enough because I want it to wrap around the edges at the very least. It doesn't have to go to the back, but it definitely has to wrap around the edge. But I can always fix that too if I miss a spot or whatever. I can use my paint marker that I'm going to use as the lines. I can do that on the edge as well, finish it off. It's mixed media, remember? We have so many opportunities to fix what we're doing. All right, I like that. I'm gonna keep on going this way. Yeah, I like these darker papers for this. Oh, we have something new coming up. You guys may be realizing that the end of the year is coming to it's coming to the end of the year, which means New Year's celebrations are on the horizon. And our little group here made a pretty awesome decision yesterday. Right, girls?
Yep.
It's pretty darn awesome. We are going to be doing a variety show for our New Year's Eve all day long, all night long, I should say, New Year's celebration. With a twist. So what we need from you guys who are watching, maybe this is the first time you've ever heard of such a thing. We 2016, we brought 2016 in with a 6.5 hour long hangout or something like that, that we went through all the time zones. That was so much fun.
Yeah, it was. It was a lot.
Many of the
fun.
People watching here today were, that was their first experience with the Kraaft Shaak, which I feel really bad for them, but they stuck around for like almost a whole year now. So that's kind of cool.
But Heather, you need to move that one down so it goes around.
I think I got it.
Okay.
Thank you. Darn, this blue paper is really, really thicker than even the coppery one.
Oh, really? It doesn't seem like it.
It's having a hard time staying glued down.
I saw someone had a tip once that if you wet the paper first,
yeah, I've seen that too. I'm afraid of what the water does to I am struggling with keeping it on here as it is. That would be really funny if I had the water to fight with as well.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe for entertainment purposes, I should.
Well, I think it was like if you missed it and then after glue on top of it. Open the fibers.
Yeah, and that's why I'm putting the glue on the paper first, because that is exactly what you need to do, but that might be better. Because once it's on here, it kind of set in a little bit, it moves and it sticks a little bit better.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. But see how it's curling up? Can you see that?
Yeah.
Anyway.
They're talking about the New Year's Eve thing. Michael wants to know if he's invited.
Everyone's invited, especially Michael, because Michael's going to be, and he sort of talked about this, so I'm sort of putting him on the spot, sort of making him commit publicly, but he's going to be sharing with us how he does his videos. So, Michael, you have to be there. I know you might have other plans, but you're going to have to break them.
Wow.
Wouldn't that be cool to see, like, have him screen share with us how he puts together a video? I mean, not obviously we're not going to watch the whole process, but we'll get to see some of what he gets to do, right?
Yeah, excellent.
And right now he's typing me a private. Yeah, that's my point. Yeah, I want to see what everybody else does. That's what I think we should be. Who cares what I do? You guys watch what I do all year long. Let's see what some other folks do. Don't you think?
Yeah. I think so. Booking talent now, folks. Sign up.
Yeah. Booking talent now. There's a post in the Crafters community on Google+. If you're not a member, you can still see that and click on the link, and you can actually go ahead and fill out the contact us form. That's a part of the website. Just let us know you're interested in it, in being a part of the program. And, you know, we're not looking for you to be the very best at whatever it is that you're going to share with us. We don't care about that. Have I ever cared about that? I'm not the very best. So we don't care about that. What we care about is having fun and having fun with friends. So come on over, have some fun with some friends. Show us what you might be interested in learning about or something you want to share with others that you figured out. Yeah, what you're working on, definitely. You're really into art journaling. We want to see you do that. If you're trying out some new products and you'd like to, you know, experiment with friends, that'd be a good place for that.
Linz is making some comments because she was kind of like the life of the party. It was hysterical. And she got kicked out of her bedroom, her slave, because she was making so much noise.
Yeah, honestly, that was our first meeting with Linz, too. Yes, that's where we met Linz. So forget who first time meeting the Kraaft Shaak. It was our first time meeting Linz. And that was the blast right there. Yeah, and her cartoons and everything else have just been a major blessing to all of what we do here ever since. So bring it. It's really going to be sad if I end up running out before I get this whole thing finished. You know that, right?
Well, then the whole wrapping into the bag, we'll just cut those pieces.
Yeah, we'll just cut those. Oh, I love your attitude. You're so like confident, like not big deal. I'm starting to panic, so I'm laying them down.
Oh, there's plenty.
I don't really believe you. I have to prove it to myself, okay? It's nothing personal, Sandra. Oh, yeah, there's plenty. She was right.
I guessed I need it.
That's going to work out to be funky.
You're going to have to cut some of them down.
Yeah.
It'll work out to be funky, isn't it?
Yeah.
But we'll be good. Yeah, we'll be good. Okay, phew, I can continue.
Oh, there we go.
Excellent, excellent. Okay, now I don't want to maneuver it. Okay, let's see.
Yeah, everybody's saying that, you know, we met a lot of people that New Year's Eve. That was fun. A lot of friendships formed that night. That was fun.
Yeah, so I would really love it if you guys would join in. You know, we're going to need viewers too, not just folks showing up, you know, and sharing their awesome entertainment, but we need people to come and watch the entertainment as well. So that would be great if you would plan to be there. I don't have it set up yet. I'll have the link hopefully ready by next week. I had to wait to find out something behind the scenes before I could actually create the event itself. So we'll have it next week, hopefully, and we'll share that with you. If you're watching the recording of this episode, and it's, you know, been at least a week since we aired it, then you're probably wondering, well, where's that link? And hopefully I will have remembered to put the link in the description. We'll see.
We have questions, and will CC and Chi-Chi be there?
Yeah, I'm not sure. We'll have to ask and find out, you guys.
If they're available.
Yeah, we got to find out. I mean, Cece's been doing a lot of classes and things. She may have already been booked. You know, she's a busy person. She's a sought-after artist. We may not have the opportunity to have her this year, but I hope that you'll still come anyway, even if it is just me.
And Kiki?
You know, so I've been talking to Kiki's agent, and it turns out, it turns out that Kiki has already got a booking, but she's thinking about showing up.
Okay.
Thinking about it. I said, is there any way to get confirmation? And I was flat out told no. So we won't know until the day of, I'm pretty sure. She might fly.
I'm thinking, Sylvia, yes. We might need to invite some other special guests.
Oh, yeah. Are we going to do the games again like Michael had us doing? That was fun.
Michael's in the audience, right? I think we should ask him. We should ask him and Andrew if they would be willing to do that. Don't you guys think? Go ahead and ask them now in the comments. That would be great.
Hey, guys.
We're kind of trickery over here, aren't we? All right. This is hard to do. You guys can't see what I'm doing right now, but I'm stretching literally across this whole painting to try and get to this. Am I all by myself again?
I was reading comments.
I know you guys get to listen. I learned something doing the Not So Live show. The comments are way better than the rest of this show. So if you're not here for the live show, you are missing out on some amazing, awesome folks who hang out in the audience and give tremendous, tremendous commenting.
Just trying to see if we have a confirmation on the game show by Michael.
Yeah, keep us posted on that, will you, please?
He's avoiding the question.
Interesting.
I know. Unless we do a spoof of his game show.
Oh, no, that would be interesting. I can already hear the wheels are turning. All right, this is looking really good so far. And where are we at time-wise? Halfway through the hour, and I've got this much done. I'm kind of proud of myself because the next thing to do is more gluing. I know, you were excited to hear that. That's not the next thing to do, actually, but it sounded funny.
Actually, looking really good at the combo, the copper and the
blue. I know, and it's really funny because I was upset. I mean, ask these girls. They'll tell you in the green room, I was really bummed that I couldn't find any more that would go with this color combo because this is really all I wanted to put around the edge. So I'm glad that this worked out.
They're asking if there's AKP today.
Oh, I don't know. Yeah, why not? Why don't we do an AKP? We haven't done that in a while.
Okay. You heard it here first, people. Let me know.
And that was a shocker to her because she was not prepared for that.
All you got to do is just write AKP and in the comments, and then I'll get your name.
And for those of you who are new, you may not know what we're talking about. AKP is the After Crafter Party, which is where you get to come into the film strip after the show is over with and chat with myself and Sylvia and Sandra and whomever else shows up. And we get to see what you're working on. And do you need a camera? No. Does it help? Yes. You can still use the chat. So if you don't have a microphone, that works as well. And it's really simple. If you've never done it before, it's the best way to come in and see what a hangout is like because it's not recorded and there are no, it's real laid back. It's not a big deal. So it's a great place to come show us what you're working on and we get to sort of chat face to face for a little bit. So that would be great if you would join in. All right, so you're probably noticing that my border that I've been using is just more of a guide. That's a big reason why I use the graphite is because, it's just really simple to draw with. You could use a regular pencil to do that as well. It just doesn't make the heavy, thick line like that. That's the reason why I use the graphite pencil. It also feels really good in my hands, so I really like that part.
They sell holders for it too, don't they?
I think they do. I didn't see one, and I was so excited about buying those. Sylvia will attest to this. I was kind of like screaming a little bit in the store.
We both were, I think, when we saw them.
Well, I haven't seen the really thick one, but I know I have a holder for a little bit thinner, bigger than the pencil. But
I have the skinny ones too. We bought those too. Yeah, don't.
Yep. Yeah, those definitely have holders, and then I'm not sure the big ones can be big too.
Okay.
And so it makes it like a mechanical pencil, pretty much.
Yeah, and it's awesome to draw with. It really is. Yeah. If you like to draw, you'll really enjoy the purchase of those, and they'll last you forever.
Oh yeah.
There's no way you'll use all that up in a lifetime, even me.
There's something about just holding a giant lid that's like, I've got the power.
I do agree. I do agree with that. I've got the power. Exactly. Wow, I haven't taken one Instagram picture yet.
Uh-oh.
Can you believe it?
That was fun when you were here doing the Kraaft It Not So Live, taking the Instagram pictures of you doing Kraaft It Not So Live.
Yeah, that was quite fun. I got to sit at Sylvia's desk and, like where she's doing the show now, I got to sit there and taking the pictures and, all the pictures that I took and posted during the show, during the recording, I took the pictures live then, right? And then I went into my phone during the not so live portion. It's getting confusing. But anyway, I went into the phone and I got the pictures off of my gallery and then posted them. And it worked out really well. It almost made me think maybe we should do the show this way all the time. but I didn't decide to do that. So there is something about doing this live, and it is quite appreciated that you guys show up here and everything. So anyway, you have a question? Yes.
Lisa was wondering what was the name of that graphite stick that you have, so she could look it up.
Okay, let me see. It is Lyra. Lyra. It's a German product.
Okay.
And we saw them at multiple craft stores. So we were at Blick. We were at Arizona Crafts or Art Supply. Where's the other place we were at? Jerry's.
Jerry's, yeah.
Jerry's Artorama. So I mean, it's a normal craft supply item. Art Supply item. You should be able to find it easily. All right, now I'm just going to use a paper towel to just sort of wipe off the excess glue that I have around. It's not really necessary because it'll dry clear, but I've got some goopy stuff here that I want to get rid of. And it's okay that I'm getting it on the painting itself. You can see that oogie. That's technical. It's a combination of what the graphite did when it smeared a little bit, but also what was on the jelly plates that wasn't necessarily permanent. So not a big deal. I do want to share this. This is kind of nifty. Remember the piece of paper we used to mix our color on?
Yes.
Can you see the cracks on that yet?
Ooh, it's starting to, yeah.
I got to take an Instagram picture of our scrap paper. All right, so I'm going to Instagram this.
Oh, your piece is looking like a quilt.
Oh, cool. Unexpected awesomeness.
Yeah.
Okay, here is a picture of the cracks on our throwaway paper. It looks like a bandage almost. And share. That's really cool. I don't want to throw that away. I don't have to. It's my studio. I can keep it if I want. All right. Bear with me while I find a place to put the brush so it will not harden. All right, so this is going to have to dry, obviously. The nice part about this stuff is that it's already dry down here, so it won't take very long at all for it to dry around the rest of the parts. And I'm not sure if you guys can see the cracking going on in the faces, but we'll Instagram that too. So let's just take a picture of the whole thing. Now, if this is your first time here, we take Instagram shots during the live show because the live feed sometimes is blurry or coloring might be off or who the heck knows why. But to make things a little less painful, we do these Instagram pictures so that way you can see what's going on up close and personal.
So Heather, Lisa Conley is asking what was the hardness of the
one I used.
Pencil that you were using, because she's on Amazon and wants to know.
Okay. This is 9B. It made that really dark, nice line because it's a 9B. I recommend anywhere 4, 6, 9, any of those would be good. And then you might want a little bit softer so you can make lighter lines. This is a 2B, and it makes like a thinner line because it's light. It's not as heavy.
Yeah, you're out of camera. We can't.
Well, here, I'll do it right here.
Okay.
So it makes a nice thin light line without any pressure at all. And I know that's hard to see, but that's kind of the point of what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So this is the 2B, this is the 9B.
Okay.
And that doesn't have anything to do with the sharpness of the pencil, it's the hardness of the pencil. So a 2B is still soft, so you'll get a nice good line, but it's not so soft that you'll get that big wide line. And then of course, as you sharpen them, you can make thinner lines, but not that's just darker, so it's a thicker line. If you took our drawing class, we went over the hardness of pencils and all that in the beginning of our drawing classes. Those are still available up on the website for anybody who wants to take those. All right, what do you guys think? Do you guys Excellent. Check and look at Instagram and see the faces?
Yeah, I'm going to go look there.
All right, I think because I don't have any patience at all, and I really want to finish this part of it before we say goodbye today, I am going to use my heat tool and add to the drawing process of this. You don't have to do that. It's best if you let it air dry. It tells you right here. Well, I'm stalling, so let's just read this. Okay, dimensional white crackle paste. At least I admit it. All right, dimensional white crackle paste that creates eggshell cracking pattern as it dries. Use alone or through a stencil. Apply with palette knife. Tintable up to 20% with media fluid acrylics. Instructions, if desired, apply base coat of media fluid acrylic, which would be a nice, if you did that, you'd have the color shining through below the cracks. So then again, that mortar or, what's the name of that stuff?
Grout.
Look, yeah, you'd have that color shine through. So if you used a contrasting color, that would show through. Which would be visible through the cracks. Let it dry. For added adhesion, apply matte medium and let dry before applying crackle paste. So that would make the crackle paste stick to your surface better if you applied matte medium first. But it needs to be completely dry when you do that. The size of the cracks are varied based on thickness of application and its soap and water cleanup. Now it is best, like I was saying, to let it air dry, but there's a certain amount of impatience involved. So we're gonna move on anyway.
Do as I say, not as I.
Yeah, I always hated that when my dad said that to me, but I've said that to you guys a number of times now. So sorry about that. But it is really cool the way it's doing the cracks and stuff. And this will actually give it some bigger cracks, too, in some areas with the, you know, forced drying time. But it really doesn't take that long. I mean, we painted this, what, 40 minutes ago?
Yeah.
And it's almost done. These big gloppy areas are what's not done yet, and that's because I glopped it on too much. What I really want to do, though, is to be able to share with you the cream. Interesting. Hey, do you girls have any comments that you can bring up on screen? Because I'd really like to take just a second to run upstairs.
They're just talking about, well, Lynn's has got this one comment. I'll bring this up. And her spelling is just absolutely fantastic on that, too.
Okay.
Come up? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, because it's not showing. Go ahead and read it then, Sandra, because it's not showing on my screen.
I had crackle paste, but it never crackled. Okay. K-double-A.
Yeah.
Oh, no. The silence. She really did have to go upstairs. Sorry, folks.
And we had a clear crackle paste, Kim, that she used, and she added some quinacridone gold to it to make that color.
I'm sorry.
Oh, Lisa posted a link for the Amazon if anybody's interested in
The pencils?
Pencils, yeah.
Interesting. Running upstairs didn't help any because I can't find it. Okay, so what I wanted to show you was the canvas we did last week. Aha! The canvas that we did last week. It's as if I had it all along, right here. Oh, brother. Okay, so the canvas that we'd made last week, I had done the exact same thing, which was the crackle paste, which is a white product. And then when you add...
Not clear. Okay.
when you add paint to it, it tints it. Now, I used quinacridone gold, which is quite dark, but because this was white, it really toned it down to more of a flesh tone, so that was kind of cool. And then I want to go over it with the antiquing glaze, which is what we did in this episode, which is what those blue cracks, the blue lines in the crack look like. That's the antiquing cream that I use. Now, I don't want to use blue on their faces. That would be silly.
Does it come in different colors?
It does. That's what a big reason why I wanted to share this is because I want to show you all the colors it comes in.
I'm just glad that you clarified what you used to crackle because I said it was clear. And so it's not. It's white. So.
Well, and that's fair that you know that you said that because I have used the clear stuff. So there is a clear glaze.
So that one that you used will not dry clear, right?
No, it is opaque.
Okay.
So if you wanted a clear crackle, which we did do on that smaller piece, that is upstairs and I'm not going.
Okay.
Then you need to use the glaze, which is a clear glass-like glaze when it's done. But so they have carbon black. These are the antiquing creams that you can put over the crackle, and then it sort of seeps into those cracks and creates this effect I'm showing you here. Okay, so they have carbon black. They have medium gray. They have white. They have patina green. That's what we put over the top of this. Patina green. Okay. And they have a raw umber, which is a nice brown. That's a nice antiquing cream there. And then they have this English red oxide. And what I'm not positive which one of these I want to use on this. I'm thinking.
Well, maybe baby Jesus needs a different color. Or did you want them all the same?
No, I'm going to do them all the same. I'm thinking this raw umber, though. Because I think this is too red. I like this brown. So I think that's what we're going to do on it. And I thought maybe if I stalled enough, you guys weren't listening to me, if I stalled enough that they might be dry enough to do it, but they're not.
Oh.
So I don't want
to. Yeah, they have to dry.
Yeah, and I want to keep heating them, but I'm afraid like this one is starting to bubble.
Oh.
We don't want bubbles. Baby Jesus have bubbles? No, thank you. But.
Maybe his nose.
Yeah, it's on its way. Here, I'm going to take another Instagram picture of this one because this one is really cracking quite well. So watch me take the Instagram picture.
So what are your plans for the rest of the piece?
Oh, that's a good idea. Thank you very much, Sandra. Oh, she gets a raise today. Okay, so what I was going to do, I have some pages that I love to use text in my mixed media pieces. I constantly am gluing down text paper, either dictionary pages or whatever. But I have some of my, an old Bible that was being thrown away because most of it had been ruined in a flood. And so rather than throwing it away, I clipped out all the pages that were left. And I think I'm going to use those pages and glue them on the body of Jesus here, his swaddling clothes, right? And then I have some hymnal pages. Again, all of these things came out of the trash. This is what is so cool about having a garbage man as a husband because he picks up the trash for a church and they throw out their hymnals every year. So I'm going to put these hymnal pages on Mary's robe, and then I'm going to use this text cardstock to go around Joseph's robe.
Oh.
And I think we'll paint the whole, we could actually do that part now. Let's paint it black, or not black, dark blue. We could do that while we're waiting for things to dry.
Michael is commenting on my rage.
Yeah, no, right. So instead of 1-0, Sandra gets 2 zeros.
Exactly.
Yes. Okay, people, AKP, I've got Jules and Michael Daniels. Anybody?
All right.
The double-digit salary.
Double-digit salary is exactly right. Okay, so these are the colors I think I want to use for this. I have a Payne's gray, dioxazine purple. I always say that word wrong. Dioxazine purple. And maybe the cobalt blue. Not positive on that one.
For the...
Nope. Prussian blue hue. That's the one I want. Okay. This is going to be the night sky behind them.
Okay.
And again, I am without a palette.
Oh,
you know, go on vacation and somebody comes in and moves all your stuff. Now, granted, no one has been in this room for 2 weeks, but somebody did.
Shadow. Only the shadow knows.
That's funny. All right, so let's just do this here. This will be a good place to end it because when we come back, we will have... you know, some gluing to do, but we'll also be able to paint as well. So there's quite a bit of that dioxazine purple. Yeah, sure. I know what I'm talking about. This is a very dark.
Yeah, we love dark.
Which is exactly what we want. I'm trying to find a paintbrush now. Wish me luck. Okay, remember, you guys, I asked you to go upstairs and get me those. I was up there, and you didn't remind me to grab them. Come on. All right, I'm taking your raise away. All right, here we go.
Back to 1-0.
I know, back to 1-0. I don't want to mix it up too much. I want there to be some variation in that, but I want to definitely cover up all of the
Move it down just
white.
Yeah, move it down so we can see what you're doing. Move it, move it, move it.
Move it. Okay, the other thing that might have been better is if I would have painted this burst.
Where's the fun in that?
Exactly. I'm glad you noticed. It's Kraaft It Live. What are we supposed to do? Mistakes well, and all, yeah. Right?
Right. Make Andrew happy.
Exactly. So as I move down into this, I'm trying to be careful around the edge because, like I said, I should have done the painting part first. I may have to go back in and add just a little bit while, so I get good coverage. But as I move down into this space here, I'm going to use more strokes like this so we get some more variation in the coverage. I want it to cover the white, but I don't want it to look like a solid dark blue, black background, okay? So it's okay to outline your images with your paintbrush and then go over that with kind of these X strokes. Now I could probably just go right on over into there, into the images and have no problem. But I don't want to take the chance because this is so dark that I'm afraid that it would, you'd be able to see it underneath the text paper.
Oh yeah.
And so I don't want that mistake, you know, I don't want it to have that look to it.
That one looked cool with some crackle on the top too.
Yeah, we didn't think about that, did we? You know, a big part of Kraaft It Live, and since this is one of the last shows for the year of Kraaft It Live shows anyway, it's kind of fun to talk about this, but a big part of what we do here is experimentation and just kind of going with it. I never do a test piece. I don't find the fun in that. Most of what I'm doing with you guys live, I know you probably can't see what I'm doing there, huh? But most of what I'm doing with you guys live is just what I would do if I was in the studio by myself, figuring it out. I don't try to have all the answers before we go live. And for some people, I know that's not the greatest thing ever, but most of you are here watching because of the impromptu fun we have here. Some of you are watching just because you really like to see me spill paint. In 2016, we didn't spend very much. We didn't spill very much paint. I wasn't very good at that this year. Some of you are here because of the people that are hanging out in the audience, and that's the best part, if you ask me. Those folks in the audience really make this show worth it. I know, because after recording two episodes, and I have two more episodes for the rest of this month that I'm going to do the same way, after recording without you guys, it's really boring. I've learned.
Lisa Conley said that she just finds this absolutely gorgeous, and she just might play along.
Woohoo! Well, after seeing what we did today and remembering, oh, it might have been better to paint this before you glued the outside edges, you could go ahead and play along and be ready to go next week when we do part two. That's the whole reason why I did it this way. You realize that, right? It's for your benefit, Lisa. I
she
do appreciate
she's gonna try. Cool.
All right, cool. I do appreciate you guys being here live, being here for all the antics all year long. It's been a great year. We've done a lot of growing here at the Kraaft Shaak and started fundraising for our new adventure that we hope to be able to do in 2017. If you're wondering what that's about, it's Kraaft Shaak on the go. And we do have a GoFundMe page if you're interested in figuring that out. There'll be more about that on our website. You can learn all there is to know. I think as this is drying, I am very happy with it.
Beautiful.
What do you think?
I like it.
It's still wet, so you kind of see some of that shine coming back at you, but I think I've got it everywhere. I like the variation in color. Do we need an Instagram picture of this? Probably,
I think so.
Yes. Yes. Yes, we do.
Like, why did I even ask, right? Just pick up the just pick up the phone and take the picture, woman.
I think Michael's leaving us. I know Andrew left.
Okay. All right, I think we're going to say goodbye as I'm posting these last pictures on Instagram because I'm not quite getting it to look right. The shine is a little bright. So I'm going to say goodbye. Remember that next week is part two. We're going to watch the rest of this get done. If you're watching this and recording and you're wondering what in the world is going on with all this Kraaft It Live stuff, check us out on the website. The link is in the description below. See everything that the Kraaft Shaak does over there, and we hope that you will be here live for the finish of this. Thanks, everybody. Have a very crafty day.
Bye,
everyone.
Bye, everyone.